When I start to think about how to talk about postpart, I sometimes like to ask people if they've ever had an experience where they stared at a wallpaper pattern for so long that they started feeling like they were kind of lost in it. When you find your eyes starting to move and trying to make order out of the pattern, but it just makes the pattern seem like it's sort of moving around. What if that wallpaper was actually telling you a story or sending you secret messages? In the case of postpartum wallpapered windows, we are hiding messages, and we're asking you to look more closely for those hidden images. In 1892, Charlotte Perkins Gilman wrote the short story The Yellow Wallpaper as an act of protest against a treatment she received after giving birth to her daughter in 1884, called the Rest Cure, developed by Dr. Silas Weird Mitchell. It was believed that to heal from nervous conditions, often called temporary nervous depression or slight hysterical tendency, someone had to be removed from society, distanced from their child, provided with only the ability to rest and recover. How far have we really come in understanding and treating perinatal mood and anxiety disorders? Birthing parents within the postpartum period still feel today that they might lose their children if they admit that they are struggling. People still fear speaking out because they don't want to be deemed dangerous or incapable parents. So how does this all fit into a wallpaper? Originally, postpart was a room within a room installation, meant to invite the audience into an intimate environment, even inviting potential discomfort. With the pandemic, we couldn't allow for the intimacy of a small venue and had to start thinking outside of the room walls. In a sense, we had to bring this often closed-door conversation to the public. This is how our wallpaper came to be exhibited on public window spaces throughout downtown Kitchener. Our wallpaper includes two layers of imagery. We use RGB technology developed by a design duo in Italy called Carnovsky, so we could hide an image narrative into a wallpaper. The overtone blue brocade pattern, which was inspired by the Art Deco brocades of the late 1800s, provides an entryway into the underlayered yellow collage narrative. When the wallpaper is viewed through a blue gel, most often used in theater lighting, the blue brocade fades out and the yellow is enhanced and made visible, exposing the hidden imagery. Postpart is a project that is now being exhibited for the third time as part of CAFKA 21. It's a collaborative project and was created by Pazit Cahlon, Nat Janin, myself, Catherine Mellinger, and Adam Harendorf, as well as our narrative providers who are international. For the Kitchener exhibition, we were really honored to be partnered both with the City of Kitchener and Climb Out of the Darkness Waterloo Region, which is a yearly international initiative that looks to destigmatize and raise awareness around perinatal mood and anxiety disorders, and was started by Postpartum Support International in the United States. We are so thrilled and honored for Postpart to be part of CAFKA 21. We hope that those who view it come to it with curiosity and an open mind, as well as a real sense of connecting and empathizing with the narratives included. If anyone wants more information or to get in touch with us, they can visit our website at post-part.com.